Welcome to the Real-Time Editor Behavior Tutorial. In this tutorial, we will look at the behaviors of the Real-Time Editor and its different modes. In this segment, we will observe the behavior which remains consistent throughout all modes, the way in which units are selected. To select a unit such as this Humvee, move the mouse cursor over the unit. You will notice that a green circle has appeared. You then press the left mouse button and another circle will appear indicating that the unit is now selected. You may also select units by using the tree on the right portion of your screen. To select multiple units, draw a rectangle by pressing and holding the mouse button while dragging the cursor to encompass the units you wish to select. All units within the rectangle will now be selected. To add additional units to a selection, press and hold the Shift key while selecting a unit. The unit will automatically be added to the current selection. To remove a unit from the current selection, press and hold the Control key while selecting the unit. The unit will automatically be removed from the current selection. To select an entire group, select the group name from the tree on the right and all members of that group will be selected. The first mode that we will be focusing on is the Units mode. In the Units mode, you are able to place units of any side and class, including objects, adjust their attributes as needed, and insert code into the Units init field if desired. You will also notice another feature just below the Units init field, which displays the unit's current map coordinates. Once you have selected a unit, you can rotate the unit by pressing and holding Shift, then left mouse click and hold on the unit while moving your mouse to alter its azimuth. This also works with more than one object selected. To alter the height of the selected unit, press and hold Control, then left mouse click and hold on the unit while moving the mouse. To delete a unit, simply select the unit and press the Delete button. A prompt will ask you again if you are certain you want the unit deleted. The next mode that we will cover is the Weapons mode. Press the Weapons mode located just below the Units mode, or if you are already in Units mode, simply press F1 to toggle to the Weapons mode. In Weapons mode, we are able to access any of the weapons and equipment in Arma. The behavior remains the same as placing units. Simply double-click on the ground, and a menu appears providing you with the options to choose from. Pressing Category will permit you to choose between primary weapons, secondary weapons, handguns, magazines, or items such as binoculars. The weapon box allows you to choose from the various items available to you from the add-ons directory. To add items to the list box window of items to be placed, simply double-click the weapon or select the weapon with a single click and use the arrows between the list boxes to increase or decrease the amount of the selected unit. You may also alter the amount of an item by highlighting it in the placement list box to the right and entering an amount you would like to place and pressing Change. When you are ready to place the weapons in-game, press OK, and the items will appear on the ground. The weapons can then be manipulated the same as units. Let's look now at groups. Select the group mode at the top of your screen. In groups mode, we are able to place predefined groups and divide or join existing groups. Placing a predefined group is much the same as the standard Arma editor. To divide an existing group in real time, select the units to separate. Press and hold Shift. Click on the unit and drag and drop a line to a nearby empty space and release the mouse button. You will notice that a new group has been created in the tree to the right. To join an existing unit to another, just drag and drop the line to the unit you wish to join. Now let's look at the Triggers mode. Press the M key to enter the map. Select the Triggers mode at the top of your screen. You may now place triggers the same way as you would in standard ARMA. Now let's look at the waypoint mode. Select the waypoint mode at the top of your screen. Unlike the standard ARMA editor, waypoints in the real-time editor are not connected to the units as a default. To place a waypoint, double-click an empty space on the ground. You will now see that a waypoint is visible, but no units are attached to it. To connect a group to a waypoint, select at least one member of the group, press and hold Shift while dragging the mouse from the unit to the waypoint. Once you release the mouse button, a line appears indicating that the unit is now attached to the waypoint. To have waypoints attached to groups by default, first select a group, double-click on the ground and create the waypoint. The waypoint will automatically be attached to the group. If you have special waypoints that involve vehicles such as Get In or Destroy, you must first create the waypoint. Attach the vehicle to the waypoint, then you can attach the unit to the waypoint. If you would like to copy a waypoint, you can do so by selecting the waypoint, pressing and holding Control, clicking on the waypoint and moving the mouse to an empty space in the editor. Once you release the mouse button, your copy will be reproduced on screen while attached to the copied waypoint. Now let's look at the markers mode. Press the M key to enter the map. Select the markers mode at the top of your screen. You may now place markers the same way as you would in standard ARMA.